Well, now, rise the ground and go get it. Like we always do around this time, I am your host, Mike Man, back with another episode of Rapper Weed TV. You know how we does. Flame them if you got them. Big back bulls burning. Go ahead, punch that subscribe button in when it's loud and lit. Lit loud, sucker for me because of COVID. I can't pass. I need 12 feet. 6 for the COVID, 6 for your pen ass gun. Tap that notification button. We got to serve. Hey, man. Flame them if you got them. Hey, man. Reporting on QUAVO and SAWEETIE once again. And like I say, I just made a post. People gonna think I'm just all up in their business. No, man, that's the hot shit going. So, hey, with that being said, it's being speculated or being said that Justin Laboy was in Atlanta the other night. Probably promoting or networking or just enjoying the sights and sounds, the ambiance of Atlanta. Apparently, the migos got wind of that. Damn. Let's just say Justin Laboy. It's been speculated he got them paws put on. He got them paws put on him, and they saying it wasn't pretty. Yeah. The video hasn't surfaced yet. And I'm quite sure it will be surfacing within the next few hours after all partygoers either wake up or come out of their respective hangovers. But I expect within 5 hours that footage will be out and about, if it is indeed true. Speculation that Justin Laboy and the interview with SAWEETIE is the reason, you know, shit was brought up to attention that QUAVO and SAWEETIE were breaking up. Now, they saying that it was over before. Now, that leads me to believe that if Justin Laboy knew that going into the interview, that means y'all had like a little pre-talk or pre-gaming or some shit where y'all discuss topics that got the green light or have a red light on them or a flag on them. I'm quite sure y'all discussed what you couldn't talk about or what she didn't want to talk about. And you can see in true Justin Laboy fashion, which is toxic, he tried to squeeze shit about her, and when he pressed her, you know, some shit came out that was controversial, or in some people's eyes, you know, at least, you know, rumor ready, or, you know, some shit like that. It was ready for the internet to gobble up, but that's besides the point, man, because like I said, and like I keep reiterating, and I'm gonna be honest. Now, I saw Trouble, you know, Trouble from Atlanta. Shout out Trouble, I fuck with some of his music. Hey, to be honest, if that nigga says something about, you know, he getting them paws put on him, it's a possibility he was probably in the vicinity, because, you know, I think them his little bros or something, he fuck with them hard. So, it's a possibility he or somebody in his camp or whatever was in the vicinity when Justin Laboy caught that beat down, because he did, you know, kind of say something to the effect to let the cat out the bag that QUAVO didn't put hands on SAWEETIE in the elevator, but he did put hands on Justin Laboy. So, man, we'll wait till the video surface. I don't know what blog is gonna be first, probably me to take out or TMZ or some shit. Just know, if this shit is true, there will be video posted within the hour, the next few hours. Soon as Atlanta wake the fuck up, I give them noontime. Noontime, 11, 1, somewhere in there. This shit will be out. The video will be out today, probably. So, y'all let me know what y'all think in the comments. Like I said, man, this QUAVO SAWEETIE shit, it's gonna get worse or get better. From what I'm seeing myself personally as observing from the outside looking in, just some typical relationship shit. We get into an argument. Now the shit about the elevator shit, I would not comment on that because, you know, people have different opinions about that. Me personally, hey, there are times where females will jump up or react or move a certain way toward a male, and he'll have to do something to either get her back or get her off of him, or, you know, try to calm her ass down or get her ass to, hey, look here. You know what I'm saying? I've been in that situation, and I'm quite sure a lot of you have been in that situation. My situation, I had an ex, break up with her. She came back to the house. She saw somebody else in the house. She tried to force her way in the house. All I did was push her ass back out the door and close the door. Simple as that. But I did get the police called on me because, you know why? She had some fucking knockoff ass Gucci glasses on her fucking head that fell off and broke. So she was mad about that. So, but other than that, man, we know how relationships jump off. So, y'all let me know what y'all think in the comments. Go ahead, punch the subscribe button in when it's loud. Little loud circle form because the COVID ain't passed. Need 12 feet, 6 for the COVID, 6 for the pin ass blunt. Tap the notification button. You know what it is, man. Rapaway TV, y'all stay tuned. Rapaway TV, the podcast will be coming to you, and we will be recording and broadcasting from Las Vegas. So stay tuned for that. Travel vlog coming soon. Rapaway TV podcast. We working, man. Y'all stay tuned. Stay safe. Stay breezy. Stay sanitized. Stay dangerous. Stay out the fucking way.